On social media, sometimes I come across comments that sound something like this. There are no waterproof sunscreens in Korean beauty. If you're looking for a decent waterproof sunscreen, Japanese skincare is the way to go. And don't get me wrong, I completely understand where that's coming from. Most of the Korean sunscreens you see on social media are not usually waterproof. So if you're only exposed to Korean beauty through Western social media, you may get the impression that there are no waterproof sunscreens in Korean beauty. Well, with today's video, I'll try my best to dispel this myth and also tell you how waterproof sunscreens are regulated in Korea. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. If it's the first time you visit this channel, my name is Odile and I work in marketing and advertising in the Korean beauty industry. On this channel, I use my professional experience to bring you informative content on Korean beauty trends and history. So if you like to take your K-beauty knowledge to the next level, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications. Today's video is all about Korean waterproof sunscreens. I'll tell you how waterproof sunscreens are regulated in Korea and share with you my favorite Korean waterproof sunscreens. This video was kindly sponsored by Stylevana, but those of you who have been following me for some time now will hopefully notice that almost all sunscreens in this video have been previously covered on my channel in non-sponsored content. So, you can find all these sunscreens and many other Korean skincare products on Stylevana. If you use my exclusive discount code, you can also get from 10 to 15% off your order. You can find all details in the description box below. Part 1. Finding the right sunscreen. When you're looking for a new sunscreen, there are many things that you should consider, ranging from your skin type to your skin tone, sensitivities, personal preferences, and lastly, how are you planning to use that sunscreen? Do you need a comfortable sunscreen that you can wear to the office and washes off easily at night? Or do you need something more resistant that won't budge an inch even after jogging under the scorching sun? And for this reason, it's important to understand the difference between daily sunscreens and outdoor sunscreens in Asian beauty. To be fair, this distinction exists in Western beauty as well, but it's more common in Asian beauty because of the preferences of local consumers. While we know that most Western consumers only wear sunscreen when they go on holiday, it was recently reported that 72% of Koreans wear sunscreen every single day. And this widespread practice of wearing sunscreen every day led to a high consumer demand for comfortable and lightweight formulas that could be worn on a daily basis, mostly in an indoor setting. Usually these sunscreens don't have a strong grip on the skin and wear off easily when they're exposed to high temperatures, water or sweat. So if you need a sunscreen to wear in those conditions, you should be looking for waterproof sunscreens, or as they're commonly called in Korea and Japan, outdoor sunscreens. You can usually recognize them because they use the word outdoor in the name or product description, or they make some clear references to sport activities. And that's because these sunscreens are usually targeted to people who play outdoor sports and need strong UV protection. An argument I came across sometimes is outdoor sunscreens are just a marketing ploy to get people to buy more products. And as a marketer with nearly 10 years of experience, I want to try and help you understand why beauty brands make the distinction between daily sunscreens and outdoor sunscreens in Asia. It goes without saying that you can wear waterproof sunscreens whenever you want. However, there are two main reasons why you don't see beauty brands recommending waterproof sunscreens for daily use. The first one is very obvious. They are hard to remove. Since waterproof sunscreens have a strong grip on the skin, they are more difficult to remove compared to a comfortable daily sunscreen. And this can be especially tricky if you have sensitive skin that is easily triggered by mechanical stimulation. And that's why you don't see Korean beauty brands recommending this type of sunscreens for daily use. The second reason is that Korea is terribly humid in summer. Speaking from personal experience, if I try to step outside wearing a comfortable daily sunscreen in summer, I would literally feel the sunscreen melting off my face after 30 minutes. And that's what led to a high consumer demand for more resistant sunscreens that could be worn during outdoor activities. Part 2. Standards of water resistance. Water resistance standards for sunscreens are different in every country. But when it comes to Korean beauty, these are the two words that you should look out for. When you see this word on the packaging of your Korean sunscreen, it means the sunscreen was tested to guarantee at least 50% of its SPF value for 40 minutes. This term is simply translated as waterproof in English. On the other hand, when you see this word on the packaging of your Korean sunscreen, it means that sunscreen was tested to guarantee at least 50% of its SPF value for 80 minutes. There's no officially approved English translation for this term, so different brands may translate it in different ways. Usually it's either very waterproof, strong water resistance, or persistent water resistance. Over the years, these standards have been changed multiple times, but this is the most updated information as of September 2022. Part 3. Top waterproof sunscreens. In the last part of the video, I'll share with you my favorite Korean waterproof sunscreens, starting from what I consider my ultimate favorite Korean sunscreen of all time. Is a Knox UV Sun Pro 365 Extreme Sun Fluid. Ever since I first introduced it on this channel, I receive countless messages from you saying how much you enjoyed this sunscreen, and I'm really happy I could help this product reach an international audience because I truly think it's an outstanding sunscreen. I tried many Korean sunscreens over the years, but in the end, I always go back to the Extreme Sun Fluid. I find that the key strength of this sunscreen is that it's a waterproof sunscreen that is lightweight and comfortable like a daily sunscreen, but at the same time, it's very resistant against high temperatures and sweat. The Extreme Sun Fluid has a thin sun milk formula that spreads like a dream and dries to a soft satin finish that always reminds me of a pore-smoothing makeup primer. Despite being a hybrid sunscreen, the Extreme Sun Fluid doesn't leave any white cast whatsoever on my skin tone. Overall, I find this sunscreen to be the ultimate no-brainer. It provides great skin body support without being sticky or heavy. The silky finish makes a great base if you wear makeup, and it's very resistant against high temperatures and sweat, but comfortable like a daily sunscreen. And on top of that, it also smells like a fancy high-end fragrance. Seriously, it doesn't get any better. The second sunscreen I want to show you today is another long-time favorite, Hera's Sun-Made Leports. Hera Sun-Made Leports is probably one of the most iconic Korean sunscreens out there. It's been around for over 15 years and is still topping the sales charts to this day. Personally, Hera Sun-Made Leports is the Korean sunscreen I've been using for the longest time, and it's what I consider my staple outdoor sunscreen. The sunscreen has a very particular texture that makes it ideal for the warmer seasons. As you can see, when you spread the formula, it breaks down into tiny water droplets that feel instantly fresh and hydrating on the skin. And I find that it's a very nice feature to have considering that this is a sunscreen recommended for outdoor activities. Despite being a hybrid sunscreen, Hera's Summit Leports is fully transparent on my skin tone and dries with a comfortable semi-matte finish that is not too drying but not sticky either. Hera's Summit Leports is hands down the most resistant Korean sunscreen I've ever come across. In fact, it's the only sunscreen in this video that was certified to be very waterproof. Sometimes I even joke that I could probably walk into an oven and this sunscreen would still not budge. So if you're looking for a sunscreen with outstanding resistance but great feeling of use, I think the Summit Leports is a nice option. Next up in line is the CMP Laboratories Outdoor Fluid Sun. In case you don't know, CMP Laboratory and Issa Knox are owned by the same parent company, which is a big beauty conglomerate in Korea that is famous for formulating all their products in-house. And I'm telling you this because the interesting fact about the Outdoor Fluid Sun is that the ingredient list is almost identical to the one of the Extreme Sun Fluid we saw before. But the performance of the two sunscreens is totally different. While the Extreme Sun Fluid provides great skin barrier support with a comfortable finish, the waterproof coating that the Outdoor Fluid Sun forms on the surface of the skin is a lot thinner and feels overall lighter and more mattifying. Immediately after application, the Outdoor Fluid Sun has just a tiny bit of sheen, as you can see, but it disappears within 10 to 15 minutes, becoming completely opaque. Like the Extreme Sun Fluid, the Outdoor Fluid Sun doesn't leave any white cast on my skin tone. As someone with very dry skin, this is a sunscreen that I can only use in summer. The mattifying properties of this sunscreen are great to keep sweat and shine under control in hot and humid weather. But during the rest of the year, I find it a little bit drying. If you have combination or oily skin, however, you might be able to enjoy it during the rest of the year as well. Lastly is the Waterproof Sun Milk by Missha. This is the only sunscreen in this video that was never previously covered on my channel. I decided to include it because it's a nice sunscreen and it's probably the Korean waterproof sunscreen that is most easily available if you live outside of Korea. Out of all the sunscreens I showed you today, the Waterproof Sun Milk is the one with the lightest and most watery texture. The sunscreen dries with a powdery semi-matte finish that is not too drying but not too mattifying either. In terms of white cast, this sunscreen does leave a slight white cast, but it's very minimal on fair skin. Overall, it's a nice option if you're looking for a waterproof sunscreen that is affordable and easily available. Plus, the sunscreen sets very quickly on the skin, so I especially recommend it if you're looking for something that you can apply on a rush when you're out and about. That was all for today. You can find all these sunscreens and many other Korean skincare products on Stylevana. If you use my exclusive discount code, you can also get from 10 to 15% off your order. You can find all details in the description box below. Thank you so much for watching and please don't forget to like and subscribe for more informative content on Korean beauty. See you next time. Bye!